okay.
Please, Papa. Please.
It's okay. Come down here. Come down.
What did you find?
Everything. I found everything.
What is all this stuff?
Food. You read the label?
Pears.
Yes, pears. What do you want for breakfast?
All right, Shalom. First off and foremost, I want to give all my honors, praise, and glories to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakak Wadash. I want to give double honor to my apostles and my elders of GMS that do real well. Starting with the apostles Tahar and Adam, the true men of Yahweh Bahashem Shai. That's the Christian truth through spirit, through the power, and through the name of Yahweh Bahashem Shai. You know, for 30 plus years, I'm still pushing, I'm still enduring to this day. Shalom to Sinsir Akim, the Christian truth through the spirit, and through the power, through the name of Yahweh Bahashem Shai, the seal of the elect of Israel, followed by the one third of Israel, okay? And real quick, you know, I just wanted to go in about the video you just seen. All right, and that movie is called The Road. You know, it's a good, it's a spiritual movie. All right, and really, man, it's about times that we're gonna come into, because you're gonna have men that are gonna be pilgrims upon the face of the earth. All right, you're gonna have men that are soldiers for Yahweh Bahashem Shai becoming pilgrims. All right, but in the midst of these men. That are pilgrims, all right, Yahweh Bahashem Shai are gonna protect them, all right. The angels are gonna be camped around them, all right, and guiding their footsteps, all right. Yahweh Bahashem Shai is gonna guide their footsteps, okay. And in the scene you just seen, all right, they found a bunker, all right. The father and his son found a bunker, okay. And in that bunker, all right, it was food. Alcohol, you know, and whatnot, and, you know, water, you know, cots and things of that nature. All right. Because, you know, in a movie, you know, it's based on like apocalyptic, setting. All right. Like it was going, it's like you had cannibalism going on, it was just cruel out there, man. All right. And he was trying to keep his son alive. All right. He was trying to protect his son. All right. But in that scene, But no, most likely. But before that scene, you know, the buildup, of that scene, you know, they were going to and fro, you know, looking for food and whatnot in the shelter, all right. But they came across the shelter with all kinds of items inside of it, you know, to keep them afloat, you know, in the days of famine, and that's how Yahweh Bahashem Shai is going to be towards his men, all right, the elect men, okay, the chosen ones. All right, because Yahweh Bahashem Shai are going to make sure that his men are well taken care of. All right, he's going to make sure that his men are straight. Okay, I'm gonna start off with this. This is a book of Saint Isaiah 65 verse 13. Therefore, thus said the Lord of Power: Behold, my servant shall eat, but ye shall be hungry. Behold, my servant shall drink, but ye shall be thirsty. Behold, my servant shall rejoice, but ye shall be ashamed. Right, man. Who's that talking about, man? Talking about the elect, okay? The people out here that, you know, that's scoffing at us. People out here that's not taking heed to the prophets of Yahweh Bahashem Shai. That's not taking heed to the apostles and the elders, all right? All right, all you people are going to starve and die of thirst, man, all right? But the men that's doing the work of Yahweh Bahashem Shai, all right, the elect, all right, the men that's gonna stand stiffly for the name of Yahweh Bahashem Shai. These men, they shall not be ashamed in the evil times, man. These men are gonna drink. These men are gonna eat. These men will be merry and have abundance. All right, while everybody out there is struggling to get a drop of water, people are gonna be eating Jordans, eating weave and whatnot. People are gonna be eating dirt, All right. But on the other hand, you're gonna have the elect out here eating good, man. The elect are gonna come across some, you know, it may come across as an abandoned house, but inside of it, you know, it has water, you know, a little bit of wine, you know, and some chicken and whatnot, some lamb, you know, a cot, you know. You never know what Yahweh Shemashai can do, man, because his ways are not our ways, and neither are his thoughts our thoughts, man. All right, so Yahweh Shemashai can you know protect his men in any form of weight, man. All right, either way they're gonna be protected, okay. But everybody out here know that's not part of this body, man. That's not part of the elect. They're gonna be ashamed. All right. This is the book of Psalms 34. And it's like it. Psalms 37 and verse 19. And it says, they shall not be ashamed in evil time, and in the days of famine they shall be satisfied. Right, man. And what's the evil time, man? All right. That word evil means bad. All right. These men are not going to be ashamed in the times that we're going to come coming into. All right, they're not going to feel no regret. You know, they're not going to feel unfaithful towards Yahweh Shemashai. These men are going to have faith in the name of Yahweh Shemashai because they know what they've been doing for Yahweh Shemashai, and they know that Yahweh Shemashai is going to protect them. All right, these men are not going to be ashamed in evil time, man. Jacob's trouble. All right. You're gonna have men that's gonna be pilgrims, man. Men are gonna be out here, staying foot, being on foot constantly, just like the movie called The Road. All right, that movie is very, very spiritual. Okay, these men are not gonna be ashamed. Yahweh Shemashai is gonna protect these men, the whole way through. All right, because they are of the elect. The elect have been set up before the foundations of the earth, man. All right, and it says, and in the days of famine they shall be satisfied, right, man? In the days of famine they shall be satisfied. My servant shall eat. You know, like I said earlier, man, you can have that elect man come across him, you know, whatever, but you know, whatever the Lord Yahweh Shemashai, you know, God in store for him, you know, whatever it is gonna be gorgeous. It's gonna be beautiful, man. All right. He's gonna cherish it because he know that it's of Yahweh Shemashai. He's gonna know that it came from Yahweh Shemashai. That man is gonna rejoice in the name of Yahweh Shemashai. All right. You know, he's not gonna worry. He's not gonna think about tomorrow. You know, he's not gonna be stressed. All right, because right now. They're not stressing, man. You know, because they know the time's coming into. All right, except for the people that's not in the know. All right, these two thirds. All right, these other low level Edomites. These other low level heathens. All right, you people are done, man. All right, the time's coming into is gonna be glorious for the elect and sorrowful and painful for the careless city, all right, and people that dwell therein carelessly. Okay, this is the book of Isaiah, Saint Isaiah 33:6, and wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times, and strength of salvation. The fear of Yahweh Shemashai is his treasure, right, man. The wisdom and knowledge of shall be the stability of thy times, man. All right, because us knowing that it's gonna be Jacob's trouble, us knowing that the evils that are gonna soon come upon America. All right, the fame is coming. All right, we know the events before they're gonna happen. Because why? Because we had the truth. We had the knowledge to have the stability. All right, to have the faith in Yahweh Shemashai, man. All right, because Yahweh Shemashai right now he's having mercy upon us. You know, to know this, to soak it up. So that when it does happen, we don't bug out. We don't marvel at anything, you know. We just stay grounded and keep pushing, man. All right, because everything's in the scriptures, man. Everything has been foretold. All right, so we're not gonna be surprised, man. When everything hits the fan. All right, the only one that's gonna be surprised are these these waste of skin Babylonian Americans, man. All right, these two-thirds, these low-level Edomites. All right, everybody's gonna be perplexed, while the elect are gonna be satisfied and not be ashamed and be taken care of. Okay, by Yahweh Shemal Shai. All right, real quick, I'm gonna end it off on this. All right, this book of Psalms 33, and I'll start at 18, and it says, "Behold, the eye of Yahweh Shemal Shai is upon them that fear him, upon them that hope in his mercy, to deliver their soul from death and to keep them alive in famine." Right, man, who's gonna be alive in famine? The elect. And then one third, of course, you know, but they're part of the elect as well. All right. But starting off with the elect men, okay? The elect men are gonna be covered by Yahweh Shemal Shai, man. Okay? Yahweh Shemal Shai is gonna keep them covered. All right. Yahweh Shemal Shai is gonna be that strong tower they run into. All right. Verse 20, and it says, "Our soul waited for Yahweh Shemal Shai. He is our help and our shield." All right, man, that's plain, man. Like I said, Yahweh Shemal Shai is gonna be the cover, man. And cover from what? From these evil times, man. From the famine, from everything. All right. Yahweh Shemal Shai is gonna redeem his men in due time. All right. Yahweh Shemal Shai's servants shall eat, you know, and they shall not be ashamed, you know, and they shall be delivered. All right. But with that being said, you know, I just want to say, Lord willing, hope your brothers are edified through the spirit and the power in the name of Yahweh Shemal Shai. You know, and with that being said, I want to say, call halal Yahweh Shemal Shai, Bahashem, Rakah Kwadash. And brothers, man, keep pushing, keep enduring, you know, keep fighting the great fight of faith, you know, and hey, man, Yahweh Shemal Shai is coming back. All right. With that being said, Shalom.